Yeah, so I've touched on the past ones. I have some time opening up, and I've just begun to look into developing two games at WPI. One of them, I guess three game-based projects at WPI. So the first of them is a collaboration with the Worcester Art Museum that explores experience design. And so what I mean by that is I subscribe to a designer vision in which game designers design experiences and turn those experiences into systems, right? And we're trying to figure out what it is that we want people to experience, and we code that, and we create assets for that, we give ambient sound for that. And then it's all packaged on whatever cartridge, disc, digital format that you have, and you hand it over, and the act of play turns systems back into experiences, right? So that if you think of game design as the design of experiences, it opens up the role of the humanities in a significant way to explore what it is to be human, the experiences of being human. And so I'm going to start a process in which we invite game designers to look at pieces of art and interpret the experience of that art into gameplay. Not to the visual format of the game, but full on into the gameplay of the game, and have those as co-located installations that help you engage with artistic pieces in a different way. Another project that I'm doing based upon both my training from LGI, but within the network of LGI, is to design a history game that explores the spatial significance of the women's movement. And what brought me to this is that Worcester Polytechnic in Worcester, Massachusetts, is well poised to attend to this because the women's movement begins in Worcester, something I was not aware of before I moved there. And it's very well documented. We have the Antiquarian Society there, and a lot of the old factories are still standing. So you get a sense of the compact nature of this city and the ways in which space allow for this significant movement in the history of America. And so one of the things that we often talk about in rhetoric and composition is the rhetoric of the women's movement, but rarely do we attend to the spatial exigencies of significant movements. And so this experience game, intended mostly for educational purposes, is to do that. And then finally, I have a third project that I've just started working with my historian of science and a person from ecology with to write an SF grant to write an ecology game. And the reason that we're doing this is because ecology is a heavily mathematics field, so it's easy to code in probability theories and ecology theories into a game space, and then allow people to manipulate that game space and see how fragile ecological systems are. And again, it's pulling from the success of games like the McDonald's game, which are serious games that are hopefully teaching you through the experience of becoming an evil overlord in the McDonald's universe, that there's no way to be successful in these multinational mega franchises without throwing ethics to the ground. And it's a very engaging game, and most educational games are not. And so we're hoping to pull from the challenge of that and putting it into an ecology game.